So, lactose. Most people consume it every day. However, there are some people that cannot eat it simply due to genetics. Lactase is a sugar that is present in the milk of most mammals, and it is therefore a key ingredient in products such as milk, cheese, and yogurt. Lactose is a disaccharide sugar consisting of galactose and glucose subunits bonded by hydrolysis of the additional oxygen and hydrogen atoms. In the lumen of the colon, the enzyme lactose fluorescent hydrolase, more commonly known as lactase, catalyzes the hydrolysis of lactose into its subunits, which can then be absorbed and digested. This enzyme is present in the gastrointestinal tract of some adults, but not all. And it is this deficiency, the most common enzyme deficiency in the world, that results in lactose intolerance. Symptoms of lactose intolerance are the result of accumulation of undigested lactose in the lumen of the colon. Here, bacteria break down the lactose into hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and methane, which produce symptoms such as bloating, flatulence, abdominal pain, and diarrhea, as well as systemic symptoms like headaches, tiredness, and heart arrhythmia. Lactose intolerance was first described way back around 460 BCE by Hippocrates. However, it has only been in the past 60 years that the genetic basis has been recognized and medically diagnosed. Research into the causes of lactose intolerance is essential to relieve the discomfort of such a large percentage of the world's population and further nutritional knowledge in order to effectively diagnose and offer alternatives. So where does this intolerance come from? Our genes, of course. Hypolactasia, also known as lactose intolerance, is inherited as an autosomal recessive trait. However, it is more complicated than the inheritance of a single gene. Certain single nucleotide polymorphisms, single base pair differences, in specific genetic positions have been determined to be linked to lactase non-persistence. These tiny substitutions might not seem like much, but they are mutations nonetheless, and certain combinations of these SNPs are seen in the genetic code of different individuals with and without lactose intolerance. Nabil Enattah and his colleagues found that there were no DNA variants associated with hypolactasia in the promoter and coding regions of the lactase gene itself. This suggested that there may be a cis-acting element nearby, controlling the regulation of lactase. So, they utilized microsatellite markers to flank either side of the gene to search for SNPs. They discovered indication of linkage disequilibrium between a set of markers upstream of the lactase gene. If genes are in linkage disequilibrium, they are inherited together more or less often than expected by chance alone, usually caused by their proximity on a chromosome. This means that recombination that separates the genes occurs a really small percentage of the time. Knowing which genes are in linkage disequilibrium allows scientists to locate regions where specific SNPs are often together. Linkage was found most strongly at marker D2S2196, indicating that the target gene marker is nearby. This was narrowed down to a 47 kilobase region, which was found to code for only one gene called MCM6. This gene was investigated in a range of Finnish research participants with either lactase persistence or non-persistence to test for DNA variations. While there were no variants present within the coding region of MCM6, 52 non-coding variants were discovered. These were 43 single nucleotide polymorphisms and 9 insertion deletion point mutations. Only 2 of these 52 non-coding variants were always inherited together in people presenting with the hypolactasia phenotype. These variants were CT at approximately 14 kilobases towards the 5 end of the lactase gene in intron 13 of MCM6, and GA, a further 8 kilobases upstream in intron 9. Further in vitro studies by Maryam Elizadeh and Ariane Sedona-Bavi confirmed that the CT SNP has complete association with either lactase persistence or non-persistence, dependent on its allele. The prevalence of the CT variant has been found to be consistent with the recorded prevalence of lactose intolerance. At this SNP, there are 2 variants associated with either lactase persistence or non-persistence. Further investigation into these SNPs by scientists in South America found that 96% of patients with the genotype CC had hypolactasia. This test had a 100% sensitivity rate. This was confirmed by Enattah, who found that people with lactose intolerance displayed homozygosity of alleles C and G at the stated markers. The T allele at the CT base pair is actually linked to increased activity of the lactase promoter, hence the functional lactase in individuals with this genotype. To summarise, there is a very tight correlation between lactase persistence or lack thereof and the polymorphisms GA and CT. These variants located upstream of the lactase gene effectively act as regulatory elements for the production of lactase, with the homozygous genotype being responsible for lactose intolerance. Consequently, these SNPs are serious candidates for the responsibility of lactase deficiency. However, they alone are not causative, and further investigation into the potential polygenicity of lactose intolerance is ongoing. Identifying these polymorphisms was a big step forward in diagnostic history, as it has provided medicine with precise DNA variants associated with lactose intolerance. This has important implications. Knowing these variants allows for effective, accurate diagnosis, as well as proactive screening for adult-type hypolactasia in children. This can therefore predict a person's biological response to lactose later in life.